Hey y'all, this is Amanda with Tap Mom and the Bay Brigade. Welcome back to my channel. This is Mornings with Jesus, our daily devotionals. And this is for Saturday, December 17th. And our devotionals start with a Bible verse and then an inspirational story and end with a faith step. So here's our Bible verse. Do not seek revenge or bear a grudge against anyone among your people, but love your neighbor as yourself. I am the Lord. Leviticus 19, chapter 19, verse 18. Now our inspirational story. Every year, I bake scores of Christmas cookies for friends and neighbors. They've come to expect them. This year, I agonized over one customary recipient. Should I take cookies to my next door neighbors? On prior holidays, our neighbors had brought us their traditional Indian Christmas dessert, and I'd given them my homemade Christmas cookies. We were cordial, if not close. That was before the falling out Rid had over a tall cypress tree the neighbors had planted that blocked our property's view. My husband Jeff and our neighbor had exchanged angry words. Now we didn't speak. I felt certain Jesus would want me to bake and deliver those cookies. But what if our neighbors were insulted and snubbed me? I didn't want to feel foolish. So I made cookies for dozens of people, but held off on that neighbor's batch. A devotion I read recently reminded me of the greatest gift of all, Jesus, and urged me to explore the dimensions of his love. Love, he's all about love. I went to the kitchen, baked 5 dozen Christmas cookies, and walked next door to deliver my gift. The housekeeper answered the door, and I went back home, not knowing how the cookies would be received, but assured I'd done what Jesus expected of me. That night, the doorbell rang, and there stood our neighbors, bearing a dish of warm, fragrant gulab jamun and saying Merry Christmas. Now it truly was Pat Butler Dyson. Honor Jesus's birth by letting go of a grudge or a hurt you have been nursing. Amen to that. Don't hold on to them grudges. You're only hurting yourself. When you hold on to a grudge, you hurt yourself more than you hurt that other person. That other person is not worried about that grudge. You are. You're more worried than they are. Forgive that person. Because when you forgive that person, you let go of that stress. You let go of that hold inside yourself. And you release that stress and you release that anger. And you feel better. That grudge is only hurting you. Not hurting them at all. So let it go. I love y'all. So does Jesus. I'll see y'all on the next one. Bye.